Okay, this sermon's entitled Teaching Children the Bible. Let me open up with prayer and then with a few verses. All right, dear God, thank you for giving us your word. Thank you for allowing us to see what it says. Bless the listeners. I ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, I'd like to open up with Psalm chapter number 81, the first three verses. Sing aloud unto God our strength. Make a joyful noise unto the God of Jacob. Take a psalm and bring hither the timbrel and pleasant harp. The pleasant harp with the psaltery. Blow up the trumpet in the new moon, in the time appointed, on our, solemn feast day. Now turn over to 2 Timothy chapter number 3. 2 Timothy chapter 3, and let's take a look at a few verses here. Alright, 2 Timothy chapter number 3 reads in verse 14, But continue thou in the things which thou hast learned, and hast been assured of, knowing of whom thou hast learned them. It's important that everybody learns the Bible. Every Christian learns the Bible, even children. So look at verse 15. Children can learn the Bible. In fact, it talks about that in Luke chapter 18, to come to God like a little child. So, of course, children can understand the Bible, and they can learn it. Verse 15 proves. It says, And that from a child thou hast known the Holy Scriptures. So he's saying here that even as a child you can learn the Bible, learn the Scriptures, okay? Which are able to make thee wise unto salvation through faith which is in Christ Jesus. So children can believe on Christ, children can be saved at a young age, and they can also learn the Bible. Now let's turn over to Isaiah chapter 54. It's biblical to teach children the Bible. It's good to start at a young age. I was taught the Bible at a very young age, my whole life, Bible stories as a child. And it's important that we teach, our children the Bible, and then, it's very helpful, and the Bible even talks about this. In Isaiah 54, look at verse 12. And I will make thy windows of agates, and thy gates of carbuncles, and all thy borders of pleasant stones. And verse 13 reads, and this is the verse we want to look at here, And all thy children shall be taught of the Lord. Now, the result of doing this is the latter part of the verse tells us. It says, And great shall be the peace of thy children. So it's very important to start teaching them the Bible, start teaching them biblical principles. I've noticed that when people do not teach their children the Bible or the things of God, that their children just, live a crazy, pell-mell, unchecked, unbridled, unhinged, no-holds-barred type life, where it's like they're living each day just for nothing. And adults are the same way. They just live a life of no direction. Totally directionless, like a bunch of lemmings following somebody else. And they're either going to follow God and Bible principles, or they're going to follow, somebody else. They're going to follow what the television tells them to follow. So it's very important, it's very advantageous, and it's very, beneficial to teach children the Word of God at a young age. Now let's look at some more verses on this. Let's turn over to Psalm chapter 78, or turn back rather to Psalm 78. Psalm 78, we see a couple verses on this. It says, let's just start off with the beginning of the psalm. It says, Give ear, O my people, to my law. Incline your ears to the words of my mouth. I will open my mouth in a parable. I will utter dark sayings of old, which we have heard and known, and our fathers have told us. We will not hide them from their children. So he's saying, don't hide Bible truth from children. A lot of people are thinking, well, children can't understand it. It's too complicated. No, it's not too complicated. Anyone who's got the Holy Spirit living inside of them can understand the Bible because the Holy Spirit, makes sense out of it all. The Holy Spirit's kind of like your tutor, and the Holy Spirit will reveal the truth to people. So it says, We will not hide them from their children, shewing to the generation to come the praises of the Lord and His strength, and his wonderful works that he hath done. For he established a testimony in Jacob, and appointed a law in Israel, which he commanded our fathers, that they should make them known to their children. So we should let our children, understand the Bible, and we should read the Bible to them and explain it to them. Okay, look at verse 6. It says, That the generation to come might know them, even the children which should be born, who should arise and declare them to their children. So we should be teaching our own children, so then later on in life they can teach them to their children, and then it just keeps, you know, just keeps going and going, you know, from generation to generation. So it's very important, and I think a lot of people are taking this, you know, they're just taking this teaching and they're not really doing much with it. You know, they may hear this, but they need to actually, you know, carry it out, is what I'm saying. So turn over to Proverbs chapter 22. It's important that we learn the Bible, number one, and then we can teach others. A lot of people, they need to learn the Bible themselves, so then they can go out and teach, you know, other people. So Proverbs 22, we see a verse that talks about this. In verse 6, it reads, all right, verse 6 reads, "Train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it." So if we train our children up, you know, with Bible principles, later on in life, they will not depart from these principles, because they've been deeply ingrained into the child's mind. So that's why it's so important to start teaching children the Bible at a young age. It's important that we teach everybody the Bible, period, because anyone who's saved is a child of God. So basically, we need to be teaching people the Bible. But it never hurts to start at a very young age. That's all I have. Let me close in prayer. Dear God, thank you for giving us your clear word. Thank you for allowing us to see the need for preaching the gospel to every creature, no matter how young, no matter how old, and also just teaching other aspects of the Bible as well. I just pray that you'll allow us to continue to grow in your grace. I ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen.